you see these lines, no?
Yes, sir.
It's looking more natural, no? The lines should be there. It should not be perfectly shiny, no? Some scratches, some lines should be there. The topic details here. We try to cover these other things. Basic X-ring diffuse. Just let me know if this is clear to you about diffuse specular reflection. Let me show you example also.
Yeah.
Okay. Show you example and tell me if this is a confidence. If you have confidence, if this is clear to you, or you want some more classes on that. Okay.
Last. Okay.
Okay. Test. Come on. We see Viren material. Viren material. We will discuss how this far what we have covered. Viren. V-R-A-Y-N. I will take a Viren material. Recording is on. Let me check. Recording. Okay, good. Okay, if you take Viren material, let's make a copy. This is the basic one. This is the new one. We know how to change the name. Clear? Sathikara?
Double click can change it.
Yes. This is clear, no?
Hello?
So, yeah, right. I can hear you.
Yes.
Okay, so, and we will just discuss about the material, not the texture, but only the material, the reflection and all. Okay. We know how to change the color. Okay. This one?
Clear? Yes, sir. Yes.
We know how to give reflectivity. Black means zero reflection. If you go more on white side, the more reflective your object will be, no?
Okay.
Open
yeah.
Preview window. If you have any doubt, if you need any more classes regarding that, just let me know.
Okay.
Okay. We had covered this.
Okay.
This will make my object reflective. And glossiness, what glossiness will do? Can you make a guess?
Maximize.
Okay. I will tell you. See. Reflection is the how the light will come fall on your object. That is the reflection value. Because reflection depend upon the light property also, no? More light, more reflection. Glossiness is your object property. How glossy is your object or how matte finish is your object? Okay.
Okay.
Remember, reflection depend upon the lights.
How
much lights are there in your scene? Glossiness depend upon the object property, the surface of the object. If the surface is very polished, very much shiny, or the surface is very dull, like a rubber, like a scratches is there on surface. So glossiness deal about the surface. So one means very polished, and if I decrease that to let's say 0.5, very dull kind of,
dull.
Very rough surface. Like you say a tire or like a car tire, no, okay. Dull, with less reflective, no reflection at all. Okay. So it's reflection deal about that. So if you want to decrease the reflection, by default it's one. If you decrease the glossiness of your object, try to give lesser value, 0.7. You see over here, the light is spreaded all over, no?
Yes.
Sometimes for interior floor you have to decrease reflection a bit, otherwise it will look like very slippery floor, no? Let me show you over here interior things. If you have in your floor inside this floor, there's no light, so I'm not able to render it out. But I just show you an example, just trying to say that if you want to give a color or any tile texture over here, the glossiness value should be less, like 0.7, 0.8.
Okay,
it should not be very mirror like shininess. No, this one, this will be like mirror. It will look like floor is very slippery, it's wet floor kind of, if it will be. So,
yes.
Try to give little less.
Point, sir.
Okay, and Fresnel, this is used for metal. If I remove this, what happened? My object become metallic, no?
Metallic.
How shiny it is, very shiny, very reflective, no? So that is Fresnel all about. Killer so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are the important things. IOR we will deal when we are going to do the advanced. We will do brittleness, roughness, we will do in advanced classes.
Okay.
These all are the basic things. This should be very much clear. Now, refraction. Refraction is all about a transparent glass, no? Like window and all. Here, if I come on my scene over here, you see we have a transparent glass over here. If I click, you see this one? Not transparent, no? So how to make that transparent object? Your reflection value will help you on that, okay?
Okay.
Black means no transparency, okay? The light will not pass through the object, as you can see over here, no?
Yes.
So if I increase the light color value, what happened? My object becomes more transparent, see? Now light is going through the object. Clear?
Okay.
More the reflection toward the white, the more transparent it will be. It's taking some time. Okay?
Okay.
And to change the color, first of all, if you have a colorful glass, most of the cases we do a little colorful glass so that it will be visible, no? If I make complete transparent over here, so it will be difficult to notice whether you have a glass or not, no? So a little bit of either green or blue color we give so that people can notice, okay, there is some window glasses available there, no? So to make a colorful glass, we'll not do from diffuse will be completely black, so that my glass will be completely white, pure glass, okay? To make it colorful, we go to fog color. Fog color is all about the density of your glass, how thick your glass is. So by default it's white. If you want to make a colorful glass, just click on the white color and you can change. For example, I'm taking a green. Most of the case we take green or blue. So here you see we have a very thick green kind of glass, no?
Yes.
Now to if we have to reduce the thickness of the glass, what we have to do? Can you make a guess?
Yes.
Tell me what I should do.
Change the value.
Yes.
Point five or something.
Yeah, fog multiplier is there. No, this is help you to reduce the thickness of your glass. No, one is the maximum. If I reduce that to 0.5. It's taking some time. You see?
Yes.
Little bit glass is transparent, it's the color is become more brighter, no? Let's reduce
0.2.
0.1, 0.2. It looks
yes.
more natural kind, like, no? Green color glass we have. Okay, so most of the cases we use 0.1, 0.2 value only for some transparent, or like maybe you have a transparent tabletop glass is there, or window glass is there, so we will use this kind of values and color over here. Clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So on basic parameter, you see over here we have basic parameter, we have a maps, we have options. So else everything should be default. Only your working area should be basic parameter, these things, and code parameter, scene, BDF, option. Just leave it as it is, not by default. Whatever there is, tick sign, whatever value, don't try to change that, okay? Whatever default is there, you will get a very nice result with the default values. If you have to change anything, go on to maps. Now maps, as the name suggests, we need some texture thing, no? Over here.
Yes.
If we have to apply some textures or this maps, whatever we have downloaded over here, no? This kind of. We have to go to maps. Now let's bring texture over here. Okay, before applying texture over here, I just like to ask, whatever we did so far about diffuse, reflection, refraction, do you have any question, any doubt?
No, it's all fine.
Fine, no, clear?
Okay, yes.
Okay. Okay, so let's bring our texture over here. Let's bring this road texture, no? Let's bring this road texture over here, and this is glass, so I will not use this one. I will take a new material. Shift and copy. Now to apply texture, okay, you tell me what I should do.
Double click on the yes.
Okay.
Change the name.
Name. What name I should do? Give. Maybe road.
Road.
Road. Road is work. Okay, fine. Now how I can apply my texture? You tell me.
Round. Click on the
okay.
Yes. Take here and diffuse.
And then I can give one diffuse.
Yes.
Perfect.
And I another one more. Run.
Another one will be on.
The bum map.
Bum map, yes, perfect. Yes. Perfect. Perfect.
And
what else I can do?
Reflect map.
Reflection map. Okay, here okay. I have reflection map even. Okay, very nice, very nice. So I will get a proper this diffuse map will give me
yes.
This road texture, okay?
Yes.
And reflection map
and
will give me little bit
drop
of reflection.
Pens. Yes.
And bump
map
will give me a little bit of bumpy look, rough
yes.
Kind of. Some portion will be up, some portion will be down.
Down.
Clear so far?
Yes, sir.
So this is the basic thing. Okay? So before going to advanced stage, I just want to make it sure that you have understood the basic concept. Okay? Now, when we are going to start the advance of texturing things, we need some more maps, you know? We need some more bitmaps. For reflection, we will take some different map. For bump, we will take some different maps. Okay?
Yeah.
Let me see if anything else I can share with you. Just double click on the road. Diffuse is clear. Roughness we will take care of later on. Reflection is good. Glossiness, obviously we have discussed. Freshness we have discussed. Only used for metals, no, not for anything else. Metal and glass.
Glass.
Mirrors. Nothing else. Refraction for transparent object. Maybe curtains, maybe transparent glasses, that sort. Fog color, that is for
the glasses.
Glass color. For glass color we can use. So we are done with basic. Let's come to maps. So we had applied diffuse map over here, my road. We had applied my reflection map over here. We had applied the bump also. Now one thing I would like to add over here. You see the values over here, the 100%, 30%, no?
Yes, sir.
This means the texture which we had applied, no? It will show the 100% value of that texture. Let's start with the bump map. You see by default we have 30%, no?
30.
Because bump map should be very less. Bump map should not be extremely high. So that's why by default we have a very less amount. But if you want the bump map of a road to be more visible, then you can increase the value over here. Maybe 32, I will give it to 90. I will not go 100%, but 90. Clear? Similarly,
yes.
Similarly, if you want the reflection, the value should not be 100%. If you want reflection to be little less, you can change the value from here, from 100 to maybe 50. You see little bit of changes is done over here. The reflection is reduced a bit over here. Okay, this way you can change the reflection values and adjust other values. Maybe let me put it to 100. And let's change the diffuse. Let's see what effect does it have. You see? You see very less amount of texture is visible, no? Let me
yes,
start
sir.
A preview. Oh, it will be more visible. You see very less amount of texture is visible. And the base color is visible because we have reduced the power of our texture, no? From 100% to 50%. Only 50% is visible.
Okay.
Clear this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's do it again to the fullest power. 100%. Now texture is visible 100%. Okay. So here we have seen the texture property, diffuse, reflection and all. The value of texture. And whether this texture should be applied or not. Tick sign, if you remove tick sign, the texture is removed from there.
Okay.
Clear?
Okay.
And this is the name of the texture. And you can copy paste texture from here itself. Here I am dragging and applying over here, no?
Yes.
With this small thread. You can do the same thing over here. Let me clear the bump map. I will right click over here and I will choose option clear. Bump map is removed, no? See over here also, bump map is removed.
Yes, sir.
Now, from maps also, you just click and drag from reflection if you want to apply the same map, no? I will go to bump map. You see my cursor is changed, no?
Yes.
I go over my bump map and I release my cursor. It will ask, do you want to copy or instance? I will take instance because if there is any changes on my texture, automatically it will apply to all other texture where it is applied, no? So I will
yes.
take instance and okay. You see, bump map, the thread is applied, no?
Applied.
Just click and drag and anywhere you can apply the texture. Clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now it's time to go a little advanced. Let me bring this aside. For advanced, let's start with a bitmap only, texture only, and then we can see how we can go a little advanced on material aspect. No? The metal, maybe we see a gold kind of metal, silver metal, or different kind of brass metal is needed. We already have done that also, but we'll see once again in advanced stage. Okay. Before that, let's go a little bit advanced on texture aspect. Okay, we bring some more texture over here and use some advanced stage texture for the road. Let's see if I have on my folder road texture. If not, no problem. I will download it. We have a very nice website. Yesterday we have talked about website, no?
Yes, sir.
And where we can download free and high-res textures. Let's start that texture library, this website. And if we can get a road texture, a nice looking road texture. See, so great textures are there. It's really nice. Okay, anyway, we have to find a road texture. Road R4AD. R4AD. Road texture I needed with advanced level of road we need to create. Let's take this one only, no? Just click over here. Okay. So this is my road texture. It should look, this is a preview, no? To just give a sense of how your road should look like. Quite natural, we have some cracks. We have some dump over here. Road. The line is not, this thing, no? Deleted some portion, giving a very natural effect. So, for advanced level of texturing, we need multi texture, no? For multiple options over here. If I go to this max, for reflection, for bump map, and other displacement map, we're going to see over here. We need multiple separate textures. So, here I'm getting those textures, no? I have diffuse. This may be maybe this one reflective and this one we can use for bump map. This all, okay? So
yes.
We already have downloaded this one, first one, no? Let's take second one. I think this is black and white. We can use this for reflection. We'll take a medium size. Take the maximum size you get here. I think the free is till the max medium size, no? Let's download this.
Yes, sir.
And again, I will stick another one, maybe for roughness. I will download this. And for this is for normal map. We can use as a displacement, or we have normal map option over there as well. Let's first download this and then we can see what use we can have with this texture. Let's download this texture as well, roughness, albedo is diffuse only, height is your displacement, you can say, or bump, normal map, and then roughness map. Let's download this one, last one. This is different rotation is different. Anyway, we got some textures over here. Let's take this Control X to our main folder. We will create a folder over here because we have multiple textures. Let's create a road folder, and here we will paste all our road texture. Control C, Control V. Okay, clear so far?
Okay.
Nothing advanced we did, we just downloaded. This is the normal texture. This black and white we can use for reflection purpose. Maybe roughness, normal map, bump map. We'll see how we can use that, okay? So these are the textures, and here we have to use. First, I will remove all the connections, no? This red line. Click and drag and then delete. Okay, clear?
Okay.
Yes. Now, let me reduce the size. Let me bring all the textures here. This is my folder. I need this one. Height. Height is like a displacement or bump. I will keep over here near displacement. Normal map, these two will go together. This is what? Roughness. Roughness I will keep up. We have roughness over here. After diffuse, we have roughness option. And this one is your albedo. Albedo is maybe reflection we can use. I will keep this here. And this color map we have diffuse map. Okay?
Okay.
Now we got some advanced level of maps over here. Now simply we have to assign it. Okay, I'll just click drag and diffuse will go on diffuse. This is my roughness. So I just double click over here and not see the roughness. Maybe somewhere. Okay, here it is below. I will keep over here. No? Roughness map.
Okay. And reflect.
A reflection is over here. This will go on reflection. Let me see if I can get any preview. Sometimes you don't get, but let's see if we can get proper preview over here. So diffuse is done, reflection is done, and this is my roughness map is also done. Now we have normal map and displacement map. These maps will help you to create your object a bumpy look, no? Rough look. Up and down will be there on my road. Okay. So apply this to map. We can take another map over here. Like V-Ray has a map. Let me first bring that map. Huh? I will type V-Ray and then N-O-R. V-Ray normal. Okay, first I should tell you what is the normal. What is V-Ray normal? Okay. So see what happened, no, Sasikaran?
Yes, sir.
When there is a texture, no, if I can come over here, let me explain a bit about the texture property. To make your texture more realistic, no, something has designed, the 3ds Max has some parameters designed. Okay, like if you apply just one texture, it will not look realistic. You see the bump value over here. It look like there is some bump over here, no? It is going dark, deeper inside, no?
Yes, sir.
To get this kind of effect, no? There is a, like, software in which you can create some extra textures. Like this one, normal map. Okay, you see? It just has one blue color and there is some particles kind of effect, no? Up and down values is there, no? So these kind of, you know, bumpiness will give you a texture, a realistic look. You see over here, this one, the bump effect, the crack over there.
Yes.
So that is the normal map. Normal map is a name given, okay, to a map that will help you to bring this kind of bumpy or rough surface. And same thing do the height map. Height map here is given height, but in TDS max we call as a displacement over here. You see the displacement?
Yes, sir.
Displacement means it displaces the things from its proper place. Either it will make your things go below the surface or up the surface, no? Which make your things little bumpy over there. So that is also a technique to make it more realistic. So there are different software which by which you can create this kind of pictures.
Okay.
In further, we can also see the things. We will also discuss how we can create this texture. Right now we are just downloading these textures, but there are third party plugins also, software also, where you can actually create this kind of textures. Okay, that we will see later on how we can create that. For as of now, we will just use this texture map to get this kind of realistic result. Clear?
Okay.
Just let me know if you don't understand anything or I'm going too fast. Okay? Is it clear?
Okay.
Anyway, see. So I have two texture with me. One is the this. This is the displacement. It's only about the black and white. The surface which go down is it is more darker, na? The surface that should go up, it's a little brighter. Same thing happened with the normal map also. See the color difference? You can see there is a bump over here, the surface is going down. So let's use this too, na, to get the realistic output. So here already we have slot for normal map, we have normal map. For here displacement map is not there, so we will use one bump map option. Okay?
Okay.
Now this normal map is ready. Now I have to put this to my real material over here, no? So it will go on my bump map and also on my displacement over here. Okay, here you will not see much difference, but on your render, when you render that, you will see the bigger difference over here. Okay.
Okay.
Let's go to all maps.
Map.
Okay, we have 90% and displacement is 100% by default. I mean displacement 100%. Okay, no problem. When we do the rendering portion, then we will see how much result we are getting from the displacement and bump. Okay.
Okay.
So this is what we call the advanced stage of texturing, where we have multiple different kind of textures to make our 3D work more realistic. Clear?
Okay.
Okay. Now I want you to try this.
Okay.
Just download this simple textures. It will not take much time. And apply this separately. Okay.
Okay.
Show your computer skill and do this. At least create this material for me, and then we will continue on. Okay. Let me see your computer screen. Minimize this. Yes, go to browser. You have login there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, nice, nice, very nice. Type their road. R-O-L-D, just type code and you will get the texture. Come little below. A bit. Yes, that one, old road. Yes, perfect. Yes. Just download the second that you have already, no? Oh, you downloaded.
Oh, yes.
You downloaded it. No problem. It will not take much time. You have four textures, four or five textures. Yes, perfect. Now copy your textures to your main folder, no, where you have your max file. Yes. Take all the textures to your main folder. Create a new one. Create a new one. Right click. Yes. Create a new view. Yes. Perfect. Give any name. Maybe road or exterior or environment. Yes. Good. Nice. Yes. Create over here. You have to do it one by one. You have to drag one by one. All will not be covered. Take one by one, that one. Yes, good.
And make it a V-Ray material, sir.
Yes, of course, of course. Stick V-Ray material. Yes, good. Give the name.
And V-Ray normal as well.
Yes, perfect, perfect. Take V-Ray normal as well. Yes, very nice. Good.
V-Ray diffuse man.
Yes, yes. Just drag and create diffuse. Okay, good.
And reflect one, sir.
Yeah, black and white. Black and see which one is black and white, which one is giving black and white value. Just double click from there. Yes, this is not black and white. This is your bumpy kind of, it will be like maybe displacement. This is black and white. Yes, this will go for reflection. Yes, nice.
And
maybe white one is the roughness one, the brighter one. Yeah, that will go for the roughness. See where is roughness is? Yes, it will make myself a little roughy.
And these two is a normal one, sir?
Yes. Give it to normal. Yes. No, not there. The normal map, very normal that you have bought, no?
Yes, these two. I have to click it this here.
Yes, they are also. This is the normal map and bump map option is given. No? Yes, perfect.
And this one is also normal.
Yes, bump map, below one. Yes, good. And where that will go? On my main material, where that will go? The normal that you have created.
This we should be go to main one, sir.
Yes,
normal one.
Yes, of course that will go.
For deflect. One second.
Where should go? Tell me. Drag and drop on the this.
Displacement.
Yes, right. Yeah, displacement. Zoom out, mount the scroll bar. Yes, displacement. Yes, nice. Enough. And one more time it will go. Where it should go? Tell me. One more option it should cover.
On here, sir.
Another than displacement, where it should go?
Bump.
Yes, correct. Do that, do that. It will go to bump as well, no? Yes, yes. Perfect, perfect. It is not applied on bump, I think, no?
I think yes, sir.
Try to do it once, because it should be green, light green color, if it is applied. Try to click and move the road map aside, no? Click on the road map, click and drag. Yes, yes, not right, not right. On the bump. Yes, now it's not here.
Okay.
Okay, so clear so far, no?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Nice, nice. Okay, let's see something else. What we can see. Okay. Try to arrange a bit more presentable so that it will be easy for you and for others as well. If someone else is trying to work on your work, try to make it straight. This line.
Alright, okay.
Make this line straight a bit so that it will be easy to understand. This going where, diffuse, reflection, dot map, roughness, this kind of thing. Okay, fine. Let's see what else we have to cover. So we have seen basic thing, texturing, diffuse, specular, reflection. We have seen advanced bump map, normal map, we have seen that this website also where we can download. Create normal map, we'll see how to create reflection photograph. Okay, we'll see that. Advanced layer, composite, download, and PBR material. And then we have to see the VREF for and all. Okay, okay, no problem. No problem. Okay, so before going further on our texture, let's go a little bit advanced on our material front. Okay, not the texture, but the material over here. What else I can tell you? Have I told you how to create different metals like gold, brass, silver? Yes,
On the V-ray material, sir?
Yeah, V-ray material. Have I
on V-ray or?
Have I discussed about how
sir, one day explain about the textile on the V-ray.
Just see if you can remember the things. I do it once again. I will take a new V-ray material over here. Okay, double click. Let's create a gold material. Let's create a gold material. Okay, just let me know if you know this thing. If you have discussed this before, just let me know. So we're trying to create a gold material, a very shiny gold over here. Diffuse color will be entirely black because metal don't have its color. It will reflect color. Reflection very high, 95-98%. Glossiness I will leave as it is. Freshness I will off. Obviously it's metal, so it will reflection will not reflection will be off. And to make it gold or shine like a gold, we need to change the reflection color from here. Right now I have a white, so it's looking like a silver. Okay, silver kind of reflection it has. To make it gold, all I have to do is change the color over here, no? The reflection color. Little bit of light yellow. Gold is yellowish, shiny yellow. Okay?
Okay.
Let's take this one only. Okay, so this is a simplest way to create any different kind of metal. This is, when you render, this will look like a gold shiny metal. Clear?
Okay.
Okay. And of course, the glossiness over here is very reflective. So environment will be reflective, will be visible on our metal. So to control the reflection, we'll go to glossiness value over here and try to decrease that, like 0.7, so that metal do not reflect that much, it's not like a
This
polished surface, polished steel, like chrome steel. It's not like that, it's not very reflective. The environment should not be visible over here on my metal surface, no. To get that kind of effect, no, just reduce the glossiness a bit. You get a very nice shiny gold. Clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this we haven't discussed, no.
And you discuss. What about, sir, on silver or something?
Yes, we'll do that. Okay, let's try to get now silver metal. So gold we did, and take another material over here. What I will do, I will move this aside, protection portion. I will rename again, maybe a silver. Okay, simple. Now you tell me what I should do. Make a guess.
Diffuse color, sir.
Diffuse color,
On black ko?
complete black, no? Yes, very nice.
Or silver.
Yeah, no, complete black, correct. Complete black. And then,
Okay, reflect.
how much?
Oh, 95%.
Okay, 95% I will take. Maybe this much. Yes, done. And what else?
What else? And color.
Maybe Fresnel,
No.
the very important
Yes, sir.
thing, we should remove this, no? This should not be Fresnel. You see, here, see the bottom one, okay? Because here by default, the environment we have, the base is white and gray color top portion. So we get this kind of
Okay.
reflection. So just see the bottom area, if this is white, then this will look like
White.
a silver. Okay, now
Okay.
to reduce the reflectivity over here, the metal should not have very much reflection. So what we will do, change the glossiness value now, 1 to how much you tell?
0.7.
Okay, I will take 0.7. Yes, we got a nice silver kind of effect. Let's go and see the preview. See, we got gold, we got silver. It takes some time. Okay. Clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay, nice. Let's get one more metal and then we will go a little advance on that also. We will try to use some texture map on our metal as well. Okay, first let's get one more metal, brass. Commonly used brass. Most of our interior we use brass as our table leg or anywhere. Very commonly used, no? So let's take one more very material over here. Double click and then just rename as brass metal. And again, diffuse will be black. Reflection will be very high. Fresnel, no. This would be very reflective. No Fresnel value. And for brass, again, we have to change the color. Reflective color should be of brass color. Maybe little dark orange kind of. This one. Clear?
Okay.
Again,
Change the color, right?
I'm sorry, what?
Reflect color or?
Reflect color, yes, of course.
Okay.
It will tell this metal to reflect not white color but this brass metal color. So when you render the your metal, it will look like a brass metal. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, so let's reduce the glossiness to make it more realistic. Maybe 0.7 will work. Okay, so we got three metal over here: gold, silver, and brass. Similarly, same steps, you can create multiple other metal, whatever you would like. Clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what I will do, first you try this. Try to create at least one metal. Either gold, silver, or brass. Create any one metal. I just want to know whether you have understood or not. And then we'll go a little advanced. We'll use some material, sorry, textures, and make our this metal look more realistic. Okay? First, try to create one metal at least. I would like to see how you do. So, close this. Let me see your computer screen. Okay. Okay. Gold you are going to create. Yes, Venus. Black, completely black. No, it's not black completely. Diffuse. No. Diffuse. Yes, completely black. Complete black. 100% black. No, make it black, diffuse. Yes, perfect. Now it's good. Now reflection. What will be the reflection value?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, that will work. Nice.
And Fresnel,
what do you do with Fresnel? Fresnel, do it once again. Fresnel reflection. No, cancel that. Fresnel
value.
Yeah, uncheck. Yes, perfect. That's done. That's enough. That's good.
And we have to give the color. That's it.
Yes.
If you say this material gold, I need to give the color of something.
Yes.
Gold one.
Yes, you have to give a gold color, yellowish color, like yellow color. Where you give? No, not there. Cancel. Not there. Remember where I have given the
color? I think reflect.
Yes, correct.
Diffuse.
No, not on diffuse. Cancel. Reflection. Yes, there, reflection. It should reflect gold color. Bright yellow, not so bright, medium bright yellow. Little darker, can I get a little darker yellow? Move toward the orange. Your cursor move little bit toward the orange. Yes, enough. Yes, perfect, it's good. Yeah, it's looking nice. Yes, you got a gold.
Okay.
Now, one more thing you are missing. What is that?
Grossness value?
Yes, of course.
Point.
Correct. Yes, perfect. Now you got perfect gold material. Okay, nice. Clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Let's see what else we can learn more on this and material front. Where is my material editor on this? Okay, let me open an example first. To explain that, I need an example gold material. Go to an image. You have different kind of gold. What I need a scratch gold. Maybe this work. You see the texture over here on gold?
Yes, sir.
You see the scratches over here on gold?
Now yes,
I want this kind of scratches on my gold to make it more realistic. Everything should not be very pure. There must be some scratches over there. You see this kind of scratches. Now the metal has, because the ornament, when the people make the ornament, they used to beat really hard on the ornaments. No, the ornament has little bit of scratches. This kind of things, it make it more realistic. I need this kind of a scratch. We will create this kind of a scratch, okay? Let's see what map we have. I have few maps for the scratches and all. Where I have saved? Let's see where I have saved that map. I think I have saved. This map, material, bump map, material scratches. You see this lines, no?
Yes, sir.
You see this is scratches. So this I want on my metal, so that it look like that somebody has worked on that metal and the scratches are there. So I will use this one. This lines is enough to create that effect. I will take this one texture. Control C. We'll go to my texture folder. This paste object. Click and drag over here. Okay. Now very simple to use this. All you need is to apply this on your bump map. And the sketches will be visible over there. Yeah, it might not be visible. Let me see if I can see in preview. It is taking a little time to update the preview. Okay, this is scratches I want on my gold metal. Let me bring this over here. So what I will do, I will put this on my bump map. Okay, wow, it's looking nice. See over here.
Yes.
You see the preview? It looked like some mistakes
like
there, some, you know, some lines are there on my bump. It's looking a good effect. Very nice. Oh, one thing more I can do, I can give this on my glossiness. Let's see what result I get. I've seen people used to do this. It is affecting my reflection value now. One thing I can just do an experiment. I make a copy, no? And for reflection glossiness, I will create a separate copy. And here, I want this to be less effective. Let's go over here on maps and try to reduce the glossiness over here. Is 100%? Let's see what it happens. Yes, better, no?
Yes, sir.
You see, the texture effect I have reduced, so it is becoming more shinier. Let's see, 10. Yes, better. Now it's looking much better, huh? So we have a shiny gold with a little bit of scratches on my gold. Like some jewelry people have did a nice work on my gold. The scratches are there. So here you see we have created a gold metal, and we have also used a texture, a scratch texture, to get nice scratch look on my gold. This will look much better on silver now, because most of the silver you have some rough texture. Let me show an example of silver or aluminium. Most of the aluminium you will see this one. This, you see the scratches over here?
Yes, sir.
This will make your this metal look much more realistic. Now see, the scratches are there, the cracks are there. Actually, this what make you this thing look more real. I will look on this. Maybe I can see. You see these lines, no? See,
yes, sir.
It's looking more natural, no? The lines should be there. It should not be perfectly shiny, no? Some scratches, some lines should be there. Okay, understood? Let me
copy
this. Let me save this, no? I can use this image to my other students also. I can show them. It's very nice. Those are good examples over here. Let me see if I can get this one. Take some time to load the image. Here also you can see, no?
Yes,
you
sir.
See the
Or
surface?
shiny.
Yeah, shininess is also their surface, not very smooth, you see?
Yes.
Let me save this one, save image. Very nice examples. And even this one, very good example. Let me save this one as well. Okay, I think that is enough. Let's now study the examples. Go to download. Okay. See this one. Nice, no? Scratches. And here also, if I zoom, you see the surface?
Yes, sir.
You see the line over here? And now let's see what we got over here, no? Okay. You can have to apply on. But here on gold also, you can see the lines, no?
Yes, sir.
If you want lesser lines, then of course we go over here and change the value. Where we had applied on the bump map, we had applied, no? Then the value to get the lesser lines. Okay, now it's looking much better, no? Okay. So clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so your homework will be try to create such metal for me, okay?
Okay.
Download this, or I can share this one. This I have not downloaded now. This simple one plane texture it is, this line texture. I will share this on your WhatsApp. Try to use this, try to create gold, silver,
and
bronze.
Prompt.
Yes, and try to create a rough surface. My scratches should be there.
Okay.
Try to download some scratches. Let me see if we can get from the website we have here now. Let me see if we can get from here. Can we get scratches? Bomb map? Or maybe. Let me try. You have to search. You have to search a bit. Just maybe spelling metal. There you go. See, we can take help from these metals. See how I will tell you.
Okay.
Let me take a good one. Let me take a good metal from here. Let's take this one over here. A little bit of, I can see the scratches over in the surface. You see the lines over here?
Yes, sir.
That will be help us. You see, we got so many textures with those lines. I can zoom and see. More lines are there, here also. Try to download this as well, okay?
Okay.
And use this texture as I have used. No? These lines will be there. And on max, this color will be there. Clear?
Okay.
Try to do that. Any doubt, any query so far?
What is it for that one, sir? On same website, isn't it? That
okay, the website one?
Yes, just right. Okay.
Same, which you have login, no?
See, okay.
Just type their metal. I have typed metal, no? You get different kind of metal.
Okay.
And for there, you take the this maps from there, no? The scratches map.
Okay.
Take different kind of a sketches map over here. You see bronze, polished. You see the surface, how rough surface they have. Try to get that texture from there.
Okay.
You see the rough texture, the scratches, no?
Yeah.
This one. Try to download this thing, and then we can use there. Clear?